Hello, good evening. Good evening, people. Let's learn about Mozart today. Okay, so let me tell you the logic of Mozart. Given a list of array, we divide the array into two equal halves each time, and then we sort the elements and then we merge them again. Okay, so let's go through the coding right now. So here first I have taken an array of elements 12, 11, 13, 5, 6 and 7, and n is the length of the array, which is length of how many elements are present, and then we will use the merge sort algorithm. So first we go for merge sort. Okay, so the definition is def merge sort arr is array from 1 to r. The whole array of 1 to r we will be taking, and if 1 is less than r, then we'll keep dividing the array into the half, to equal halves. Okay, so again, so merge sort will divide the first sort element, first half, and then the second one, merge sort ar plus m plus 1. Why are we writing m plus 1? Because for the first half we have taken 1 plus till the mth element, then the second half starts from the m plus 1th array index, so it's written m plus 1 till r. Then again we'll merge the both the elements. So for this we'll go for the next function. You heard df merge array m. One is there for the first element, m is for the middle element index, and r is for the last array index. So n1, we are taking the last element of the first array, which will be given by m minus 1 plus 1, and n2 of the last element of the second array will be given by r minus n. Then for we will be creating two temporary arrays. L is for left hand side, R is for right hand side, into n1 n2. Now for the remaining elements, we'll copy those elements in the data using the for I in range function. AR 1 plus I will store all the values in left. If it's in n2, then we'll write array of m plus 1 plus j elements, store in rj. Okay, so I is the index of the first subarray, j is initial value of the second sub index array. Now while I is less than n1 and j is less than n2, we'll store all the left array elements to array of k is the merged array. We are merging first and second subarray into a total subarray, into the total array. So that's why we'll store in rk, where we'll increment the I function plus 1. And same, if this condition fails, then the condition will be r of j is less than or equals to l of I. Then for that condition, we'll put all the r of j elements in array of k. Now for the remaining elements which are left over, we'll be using this function while I is less than n1. All the left array elements will be stored in array of k. We'll increment I and k, and then for j less than n2, we'll store all the right hand elements into the array of k, j plus 1 and k plus 1. So we get we'll get the merge sort. So here we'll be passing the merge sort array and we'll be printing the value. So let's check the value. It's taking some time. Okay, given array is 12, 11, 13, 5, 6, 7, and we'll get the sorted array in 5, 6, 7, 11, 12, 13. Merge sort will divide each array into equal halves until each one elements are there. Then it will merge the elements. So that's how we swap the elements and we'll get the sorted array. Thank you. Thank you.